So this is for all the guys out there who are trying to rock that modern gentleman's vibe kind of hairstyle. You're gonna go for a down fading technique that keeps the taper low and blurry without pushing this haircut too high, getting rid of that gentleman's flow, alright? Definitely wanna make sure you show this to your barber, alright? I'm gonna start with a three. I'm gonna come in right to the occipital bone, the middle of the ear, and stop there and flick out. Now we're gonna go in with our two guard on, with the lever all the way down, meaning open, and then we're gonna go right underneath that and flick out. With that done, I'm gonna go ahead and close the lever with the two guards still. Repeat the same process, this time a little lower. Now we're gonna tap on the 1.5 guard, repeat the same process, lever all the way down, open, a little underneath that too that we just did. With that done, we're gonna close the lever a little underneath what we just did. On to the next one, of course, it gets to the right. It's the one guard, we're gonna slap it on, push it open, repeat the same process a little lower, flick out all of it. I even know, bitch, don't tell me that you model if you ain't been in vogue. Then gets the right, close underneath that one open we just did. Now after the one, we're gonna go in with no guard, lever open, same process at the very bottom. And for all my barbers out there who are learning this technique for the first time, be patient. It does take a little bit longer because you're keeping things lower, typically with a down fade. There's no guideline, so you might get lost, but in due time, definitely a viable technique. After that, I'm gonna close it, go for the very bottom, and flick it out. And for my last part, I have to go halfway. And before you detail, you wanna make sure you go in with your trimmers, get the sides, and that way you can refine the fade. So with that said, now we're gonna go in with our half guard open, and this time we're using just the corners to detail dark lines and dark spots. Again, not all hair type head shapes are the same, so don't be afraid to trigger play. Go up and down and find that right length so that dark spot goes away. So as I'm getting higher to detail, I'm actually floating above that dark spot. So I'm not digging into that dark spot, I'm more so floating right above it, gliding the guard right above the hair. And for that weight line above here, you want to go in afterwards with scissors and comb to soften it up. And there you have it, with the down fading technique, I was able to keep it low and blurry, but it blends in very nice with this longer gentleman brush back.